should get them, honestly. Bother using that. It's just good for your eyes. I think it stops it from, like, drying out, and it stops your eyes from, like, getting worn out, basically. I don't know. I think gunners are good. I'd never actually gotten into it, but I thought about buying some last year. I do get how the Boshi level works. It's just fucking hard. Glasses and asthma. I am a true nerd. That is so fucking true. Holy moly, it could not have been said any freaking... It's hard. The game is fucking hard.
Mess with the bull and you get the horns. Mess with the fucking horns.
Come here. Wanna mess with the bull? Don't be at me.
Mess with the bull. Mess.
Just like crazy. Where's my off overlay off? Whatever you guys will do. Alright, I'm against Zed mid. He has Doran's shield. He's probably gonna be pretty hard to push out of lane, but I'm just gonna farm early anyway. I want this CS, so I'm just gonna push him away so I can get the CS and miss the CS. Nothing can hold me back. Thank you very much, you sound beautiful, you sound beautiful. Well, this guy's actually played the early game better than the set player I faced like a couple of games ago on All-Star. He just needs to play aggressive because he has easy trades against me early. So he might as well just play really aggressive. He's getting heal level 2. I think it's probably the best option to go for in most cases, unless you're going all in at level 2. I think heal is really solid to get. Oh my god, my fucking trample keeps fucking up my CS. I missed like 3 CS because of trample. My passive, that is, does AoE magic damage after I use the spell. And I look really mad. Like, in most cases, it's actually better to get 2 levels of headbutt before even going pulverize if you're only trading in lane. But the thing is, there's always a possibility that you're gonna get ganked, that you're gonna... that he's gonna overextend so you can pulverize him into the tower. There are, like, so many things that you need to take into account. That's why I always get Q at level 3, even though just getting headbutt would be better for trading. But yeah, earlier I'm just pretty much farming. I'm not gonna do anything too crazy. I actually read up on LoL Wiki and I figured that it might actually be better to max headbutt first for the poke. It actually increases your burst overall more, but it gives you less combos but more burst when you actually combo. And more poke. So it gives you a better laning phase, so I feel like maxing headbutt is probably the way to go. Gives you slightly less wave free, but you have trample and you have the base damage of pulverize, so it's not a big deal. CS, we're about even. He's like 1 ahead or so. Which is about like he should be slightly ahead of me. Early game. I think I'm gonna push out the lane once the next creep wave hits. I'm just gonna like pulverize it and go ham. So I can base. Trample always misses CS. Why does it never, like, actually just, like, randomly give me a CSO? I'm like, oh, this is great, Trample. It's always like, fuck you, Trample. Oh, thank you, Trample. Alright. Let's go for the infamous triple Doran's Ring build. I like this build on Alistar because his ult is great with resistances. Or with health, sorry. It's great with health, so triple Doran's just gives you the amount of health that you need and it gives you mana regen. Alistar, like, you don't build other mana items except for Lich Bane, but that's not really considered a mana item. Just, like, you don't buy for the mana, it does give some flat mana, but you don't buy, like, Athene's or a Tear or anything like that. So triple Doran's good for your early game. I don't always buy it, but... kind of depends on the game. What's going? So he didn't base yet, and I did. So he should have definitely based. Because now I have an item advantage on him for no reason at all. Oh well. He got 6, I need to be careful. I'm gonna get 6 after this creep. My ult is good against his ult, because it reduces damage I take. It's kind of like a mini Kayle ult. Got my headbutt up really soon. Nice job on the counter gank. It wasn't really needed, but it's always appreciated. Gonna start building towards a Sheen. Gonna get one more ward. So I don't have ult for a little while, so I wanna make sure that my lane is properly warded. I'm going straight to blue. Sonya's on Alistar. It's almost always my very last item, but I prioritize other items before it because you don't really like a lot of champions. You need the Sonya's early against champions like Sed, but Alistar has his ult, so he actually like doesn't really give a fuck. It's like, yeah, like I can build Sonya's, but I'm already really tanky and I'm really hard to kill, so I might as well just build damage instead. That's why Alistar is so good, because you can just build damage. Like, you're still gonna be really hard to kill. And you're gonna get, like, freaking crazy amounts of AD from your ultimate. I don't know. Alistar's kid just has so much potential. Darius agreed with me. When I said AP Alistar, he was like, yeah, I've just been waiting for someone to find out Alistar. Because he says, like, Alistar's kid's, like, broken, but he'll need to figure out like a way to play him, and he always felt like, even though AP Alistar's been played before, he's never been played at like a high level ever since his nerfs in season 2 or late season 1, I'm not sure when. I think they nerfed him late season 2 because of the jungle Alistar, but then the nerfs got reverted because the jungle changed so much that Alistar would suck in the jungle anyway. I think it was his headbutt range and base movement speed. So yeah, my trades are decent right now, but you'll see them getting like 10 times better with the Sheen buy. My trades are gonna be completely insane with Sheen. Oh, holy shit, dude. That's a little bit crazy. Like, I was gonna kill him eventually. Waiting for my Q to clear the wave. Actually, I'm just gonna W this rock trample. So that has no ult, so I don't really fear him killing me. Okay, I got Sheen now in boots. Fucking kill. Got Sheen in boots. I kind of have wards, so I just kind of want to get potions right now. I already have some wards up. Also, I'm so fed now that even if I get ganked, I can get away by headbutting them away. Oh, holy shit, what a god cocoon. Wow, that's pretty crazy. Where are you staying? I don't have my Q for a little bit. So what you can do is you can headbutt and then auto while they're in the air. Like, I can't really show it because it's being too scared. The Souling Dragon. That item is so effective for Souling Dragon. The Spectre Ray. It gives us so much like mana and... Yeah, you see that headbutt was like 25% of his HP because I... Oh my goodness. Holy doggers. I'm just waiting for Zed. I think he might fish check me because he thinks I'm gonna go kill his team. I'm gonna pop ult right before my combo. Oh my fucking god. Zed's smart. He ain't dumb. I have no ult now, so I need to be careful. That was a really smart play by Zed. He didn't get BD or anything. I just clicked when I knew I was about to use my combo. Like, the second I ulted, I was gonna combo, but then he warded him back though. So, really well played by Zed. Honestly, if that would have happened again, I would have done the exact same play. He has a ward here. He thinks I'm going bottom. So I'm gonna sneak up behind him and get a free trade. Or just force him away.
Now I'm angry.
Oh my god, I misclicked so I didn't get my auto off. Getting the auto off is just as important as getting your freaking spell off. Said didn't ghost. There's like a 30 seconds delay or something on the stream. So. There's a base delay now on Twitch. We should just take the air blue instead. I think our blue's gone.
I know the
we're good there, Blue.
Now I'm angry.
Oh my god, at least smited it. Lee didn't even take our blue. It was pretty free though. I was like fully expecting Lee to take it. Yeah, I know how to spell though. Right? I just misclicked and I didn't bother correcting myself. What's the point really? Let's go for it. I'm not sure if they see me. Yeah, they do, but I think it might be too late for them. Holy fuck, is Yone as fast. Oops, lag. Oh my god, this game is so hard. The Zed is playing super safe. Zed is actually playing really well. Overall, he's playing pretty well. I wouldn't be surprised if he was smurfing. They're trading top tower for mid tower. We need to get a fight here. Slow him. We can chase him. He might die from the ignite anyway. Okay, so we got out in a 2-for-2 in that. We had more people though, so that's not really worth it. It's worth it because I got double buff, but overall for the team, it's not really worth it. I got the 3-man Q, so I think we should have won that harder for sure. I don't really know how we didn't win that any harder. We only went even with a double buff on top. But I think we should have won it harder. I didn't see what she flashed. I have ults here. I pop my elixir there. Now I'm angry. But she's too fast, she has mummy boots already. Good job team. Oh fuck, they got dragon. Not so good job, team. Oh god, this Lucy love farming mid. Tower at least. That's like barely out of range. Kill. I'll be able to get her. Ugh, this kind of sucks. I should have waited like one more second. If I'd waited one more second, then me using my ult there would have procced my Lich Bane and I would have had a much cleaner kill. I didn't even get this kill because of it. gonna go get blue now with my large rod. Actually, fuck it, I'm gonna go for this instead. I think boots are just really important on Alistar. Movement speed is so important for catching people. So that's why I'm just focusing boots over the rod right now. I hope it's worth it. We'll see. I split push. I can beat anyone really easily. I can probably escape 1v2. I can't kill 1v2 unless they engage at different times. But I can definitely escape. Except for if Draven has like a... Zed is coming for me as well. I'm gonna hide in this bush. I could probably kill the one if the face checks me. I think Draven is gonna go for golems. So that's a really standard like AD carry thing to do. Wait, what the fuck? Did he go red? What did he do? He just like abandoned like four creeps for no reason. That kinda... I feel like they're setting up a trap or something. I don't know, is that Leona up there? They're just doing some next level shit. Using spells to proc Lichbane. Lichbane has approximately the same cooldown of my trample, so I can just look every time I trample. Times out, I can use a new spell. Let's go to free tower. He's not scared of me, he's underestimating my damage. There are three people here though, so I'm just gonna go back. Got a free tower, so whatever. I don't really care. Just got free Baron. I didn't even think about that. Good job, team. They abused the split push. Draven is in here somewhere. He's in here. What the fuck is all the way up there? Why is she playing so aggressive? Oh, Zed's there. Yeah, I knew someone was gonna be there. Good cube on Leona. Oh, okay, I guess my team is not here. That's fine. It's okay. It's well played by Leona, though. Fuck. Good exhaust. Oh wow, that was a good flash hook too, but unfortunately Zed had flash too. Okay, I'm gonna get DFG after this mid wave, and I can one-shot people. Yeah, it's hard to speak Danish after speaking English like every day for a while. I did a Danish interview and I was just, like, stumbling over my words and stuff. Danish is also a really hard language. It's like, I believe it's one of the hardest languages to learn after all the Asian languages, like Japanese and Chinese and all that shit. I wish you could see me now. What is he coming off? He's just like, how does the Trindamere kill me? I don't really care. I'll just die to Trindamere. I'm all the way bottom, guys. I got DFG now. Oh my god, please run. Oh wow, just kill them all! The Sivir though! The Sivir though! The Sivir though! What a beast. It Yeah, the pronunciation of Danish is really hard.
Nothing can hold me back.
English is really fucking easy to learn. Saw me and I had to laugh, you know I'm not who I was.
Now I'm angry.
You were there, you were right above me. And I wonder if you ever love me just for who I was.
Kill.
Yeah. And the pain
came back again.
Oh, misclick. Fucking hell, dude. I'm so bad right now. Got him, Chief.
He's
playing pretty bad this game. I feel like we're missing someone. Yeah, we're missing Sivir. It's okay though. Chernobyl's gonna kill them all. Damn, my combos are so far off. It's like pretty bad. Oh, the spin was not enough. Oh, at least it's missing two. Thresh with the double kill, of course. Son of a bitch. We get tower. Oof. Job. I'm gonna go get blue buff. See if I can get a freaking combo off. Why do I always get wards and sell them like a team fight after? It's just like I buy them and then if I don't have like anywhere useful to place them, like I ran straight top lane I think, and we already have wards around here and here. So I can really use my ward except for like some pointless plays. Even if I ward mid, it's pretty pointless because we're pressuring the top side of the map. And then I need the slot for an item after the fight. That's why I do it. It's not optimal, but the damage over time is from the trample. It does 60 damage per second right now. Oh god, they saw me. Oh fuck, we gotta run. Once again, I played that bad. I did not auto-attack Draven with my fucking Lich Bane that does like 400 damage on an auto-attack. Even more, because I popped my ult. Did like 400 damage, 500 damage, and I autoed a creep. Like, oh, I'm the worst. Actually, plus DFG as well, it'd probably do around 600 damage because I had Deathfire Grasp, which increases the damage. So yeah, I'm pretty terrible at this game. Can we just all agree that? That I'm just like really bad, and yeah, that's pretty much it. I have DFG up soon, I can kill Draven. Everywhere now. Got him, Chief. I got him, Chief. Shouldn't have been here. I don't know, I have this really good singer on my playlist. I feel like he's a really good singer, but apparently he's like a Christian singer. So randomly like Christian songs pop up on my playlist. I'm not like overly Christian or anything, it's just like I heard him once through another like radio on my Pandora and I was like, I like this song, then I just added it and then I realized that he's like some Christian singer or something. The song that I listened to before wasn't like that Christian, but then, yeah. Now there's a lot of like random Christian songs on my playlist. My voice stuff now. Sivir. Oh my god, the Draven mechanics. The lifesteal was not enough. I am born Christian, yes. I'm not that Christian. I haven't been to church for like 2 years. Oh god, I don't know if that's like really bad. Please don't hate. I haven't been to church for a while. Actually, rather like a year. Because when I was really depressed, I actually went to church. I remember. Not that often, but a couple of times. Praise the sun. Not a bad song though. This one. I don't know. I don't care. I'm a legalist.
Mess with the bull and you get the horns.
What is he doing there? I have a feeling they see me, dude. They fucking see me. Did they see me? Okay, just kidding. Oh, he's up there. They were babysitting Draven taking red or something. Don't wait for luck. Nigga, did you flash? Let me heal you, friends. Yeah, I know, it's pretty BM that people just go and they have problems. I know, it's pretty fucking BM. When I wasn't depressed anymore and I stopped going, it felt really bad too. At least I went at some point. Better than nothing, I guess. Oh, and then I go to Christmas at... I mean, I go to church at Christmas. Oh my god. My ult timed out. I feel like I'm always dead when I'm playing Alistar. I'm like dead all the fucking time. I don't know if I'll play Alistar in the LCS, maybe. If you come from another MOBA, I don't know, you should do your research before you play. Like, you must have some kind of understanding of what kind of roles you like playing in Dota. If you like playing assassins, if you like playing... I don't fucking know. Like, if you like jungling, I know jungling is way different, but it has some of the same, like, similarities in League. But, like, you just need to have... You need to have an idea of what League is compared to what Dota is when you go into the game. Don't expect it to be the same game. Please don't look down on League if you're starting it, because then you're just never gonna enjoy it and you're just not gonna like get into it if you are like, holy shit, this game is like worse than Dota. Because like, just think that it's another game, but it has similarities to Dota. And then just realize what the similarities are and what the differences are. And what you would like. It's good to have like a game plan. Like, pick up a couple of champions, pick a role that you think you'd like to play, just try different kind of roles, and then figure out like a role and then a couple of champions for that role. Play like three different roles mostly. I don't know. It's hard because it's been a freaking long time since I started playing League. It's been like 3 or 4 years now. Draven's on there. Lucian is too much MR. Once again, I fucking autoed the wrong guy with my Lich Bane. It's so hard when they're all like clustered up in my knockout. Oh, I got Lee Sin. Oh, fuck, nobody dies. This game wasn't very good, but it's okay. Next year I'll be better.